before I start building, I always checked what everyone's installed. Okay, so what's going to happen is that's going to slot into the existing ceramic plumbing, and this cap's going to sit over the top of it, up there. Like so. Well, that's it. I've got to crawl up through that gap there. I've got to put that in the outlet over there. Okay, so that's it. That's the successful mock-up of the toilet. It taps a little bit close to the toilet base, but I'm going to use one of these. You can't really see it there, it's wrapped up for protection, but it's a square one. I'll just angle the outlet here. I'll angle that in toward the cistern inlet, which will fall just out that hole there. And should be all good. That's the cistern inlet there, and I install that when I install the toilet. So while I've been building, I've just had the pipe covered with this plastic, and that's it. Now it's ready to go. I just pull out this toilet paper I've had in there. Just to stop anything from going into the pipe. So this is from the test from the other time, the first test. I'm going to pull these two apart, and I'll place a toilet on it just to make a second sure that this is the right gap. Okay, so I'm just checking it for level, and you can see that's fairly level there, and that's just with a little bit of a chock under the right hand side, and luckily it sits well parallel with the wall. You can see there that's fairly well level. So again, to get it parallel with the wall, I'm measuring off these two back points here. That's the edge of the base, and that where the curve is, that's about 85. I don't have imperial measurements on this tape, and it's 85 there. That means that it's straight on. So this is the third of these type of toilets I've installed, and what I'll do once the cement's under the base, I'll just go ahead and peg these two holes here so I know everything's in place. I've just made sure that the cistern is back on the wall so that won't move. So when the toilet's all in place, I'll go ahead and I'll slip these pegs into those two holes there. So now that I've got plans and I understand fully the dynamics of the toilet, I'll take it apart and I'll check the PVC pipe going into the outlet and I'll glue it. Okay, so I know the gap or how far this pushes into the PVC tube. I'm just going to go ahead and mark that with a CD marking pen. And I'll line it up the same way for good luck. So this pink one is the primer. I'm going to put that on the inside of the PVC pipe. And on the outside of the toilet coupling. So I'll now go ahead and join up the two pieces of PVC. Just turn it around so you can see. And on the coupling, put plenty on. Okay, so now I'll line up the two marks I had before, push them together. I'll go a bit past that mark to there, and what I'll do now is I'll just hold it there for about, 30 seconds, because these do come apart if you let them go too early. What I like to do is just wrap the lids around like this for the next time I use them. Hopefully that preserves them a bit better. I'll just sponge where the cement's going to go, just for good luck and extra grit. So this tap here is a little bit too big. I'm not really sure if I could get it off once I've got the base installed. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this off and put on the tap that'll be there that I'll use when the toilet's in place. So I'll go for a bit of walk and turn off the water outside the front of the house. Okay, so I know that there's going to be plenty of space here to put the water hose and connect to the system. So I find this thick gauge plumber's tape works much better than the thin white stuff. I don't know what you've got in your country, or if you're in Australia you probably notice that there's pink plumber's tape and white plumber's tape. So I put plenty on and wind the thread onto that. One, two, and I've got seven rotations. So I found that with the cap, it meets the cap at that point there, which is good. I can just exit from there and connect to the system. That's a good, clean, good-looking position. So I'll leave it at that. Okay, I've got the toilet positioned in place. I'm now going to mark the outside. So when I've got cement, I know where to put the cement. Okay, I've got good quality cement and I'm going to mix it 50-50. That means 50% cement and 50% sand. Okay, so a really top class tip. Always keep your cements and your glues, anything that goes hard, keep them new, as I've said before. Throw out your old stuff, always
use new glues and cements, anything that cures. Okay, so you can see the consistency, it's able to just sort of fall off. It's got plenty of moisture, so I'll put that in a bucket now and I'll take it up to the working area.
Okay, when you put your cement as the foundation for your toilet, you want to make sure that none gets down this tube here. So, I'll put plenty here. I'm going to put some around the edge here, not too much, because as I said before, you don't want it getting down that the hole there. So, okay, that should do it. Keep it a bit away from that area there. Want plenty here to lock it in. So I'll take the dirty gloves off and go and get the toilet. So you can probably see the toilet there. So I want a lot of cement around here, and I want this to squeeze in the cement, and there's holes at the side here. I want the cement to come out of them. So as I said before, I dropped these two anchors down to connect the cistern to the toilet base, like so. It's a warm day today, and the water's being sucked out of the cement pretty fast. I've got to just bring it up a bit on this side. Okay, that's just about it there. Okay, so once you've checked that it's reasonably level, and you've cleaned around the base and made all the adjustments you need to, and I've taken the system off and I've measured back from this point to the wall, that point to the wall, and they're the same, so that's squared up. So once you've done all your checks and everything's looking sweet, then what you need to do is get at least 3 buckets of water, throw them down the toilet. That unblocks any problems. And if, say, for instance, when you put the toilet base on and any cement got into the pipe, then this will flush it free. And the other important thing, of course, is without a water lock, you get the terrible smell from the sewerage coming up from the sewerage and out the toilet. So if you put a bit of water down, it creates a water lock and it cures that problem as well. So I previously installed the inlet. That's the inlet there, and the flush for the cold, big flush and the small flush. And now I'll install the water inlet. nice level on the top. And these bolts there, the two of them, they drop down.
And you just tighten them up.
And you can get it level that way. Now we'll get out some silicon. I've just put a dab of silicon behind here just to hold the system to the wall. Seat just tightens up.
The two bolts just there. And that's your system bolts there. That's the inlet.
And that's the tap. Okay, so it's now time to connect the hose to the connect the system to the toilet.
So that's just going to connect there to the tap.
Now I'll connect the cistern inlet, connect the hose. So I just get them finger tight and then just give them a little tighten more with a shifter, just until they're snug sort of thing. Turn on the tap. Now what will happen is this lever here, this float, will go up and stop it. Like so. And then what happens is when you push this button on top of the system, you push this and some information I really wanted to pass on was that rubber boot that went over the old ceramic sewage pipe. What you can do is, because there may be a leak, you can put a little bit of silicone around the rubber boot and around the ceramic pipe, and then just put the rubber boot on, and there won't be any issues. When you get the rubber boot, you have to tighten up two metal sort of straps with a thread on them, and they also do a good job of stopping any leaks. Yeah, but just put a little bit of silicone around the rubber boot and you'll be set to go. Okay, so there's underneath the toilet, and I just wanted to add that when installing the PVC pipe connection to the old ceramic pipe, it's a good idea just to put a little bit of silicone around on the inside
at the joins just here and here, and that way you get a better seal. But I've put three clamps on there. There's room on the top for another one, but that's working well.